Good day, future engineers. Let us now proceed with our sample problems. So sample problem 4 and 6. For sample problem 4, two wedges A and B. So given taog duha ka wedges, then naatay angles with respect to the vertical. So angle to sa ilahang inclined surface. With two wedges, naapod tay block C. And given put taog coefficient of friction for all contact surfaces. So, ang ginapangayo sa problem is to solve for force P na kailangan i-apply sa wedge B para ang block C is magbigay ng iyang motion or mag-start or mag-create o impending motion sa block C. So, ang possible na direction sa motion sa block C pag-apply sa force P is that block C will move to the right. Tapos ang wedge B is will move downward. Okay, so to solve for the minimum force required, ang una natong i-consider sa ato analysis is ang wedge B. So i-analyze natong FBD sa wedge B, and then we will solve the reaction between sa contact sa body B or wedge B and sa block C. Once makuha nato to na reaction, which is in terms of variable P, ipasa to nato sa block C. And then we will relate that reaction na in terms of variable P. We will relate that to this given value na timbang sa block C, kaning 10 kilonewtons. Okay, so let's start sa FBD sa wedge B. Okay, so sa wedge B is exposed na to mga forces na nag-a-act sa iya ha. So naa siya'y kaning applied force P, which is unknown. Then the react class is walay weight ang wedge. So in most problems sa statics about friction sa wedges, walay weight na ginahatag in most cases ang wedge since ang iyang weight is very small or pwede ra ni mo i-neglect. So, same sa kanina problem, walay weight na nag-exist for wedge B. So, aside from applied force P, may reaction na makreate diri between sa wedge A and B. So, una natin i-draw isang normal reaction. So, perpendicular lang siya sa inclined surface, and let's denote that as N sub 1. So, for components, i-draw na lang nato siya with color blue. Okay, so that's N sub 1. And then let's take note ng impending motion sa wedge B is panaog. Since panaog ang iyang impending motion, ang ato ang friction diriya is dapat pasaka. And let's denote that as F sub S sub 1. And with respect to the vertical, ang angle sa F sub S sub 1 should be equal to 6 degrees. Since kani is 6 degrees, no, ang angle sa friction sa kaning vertical line, so pareha lang po diriya. Dapat 6 degrees po na yung angle. And then sa wedge is, mas dali siya isolve kung i-convert na to ang mga force reaction components as 1. So, kuha na tong resultant. And let's denote their resultant as R sub 1. Based sa concept sa angle of friction, magamit nato ang angle of friction na angle between the normal force and the resultant reaction kung ang imuhang friction force is na-maximize or sagad ang iyang value. So let's denote this as angle phi sub s. So based again sa concept sa angle of friction, natay formula na ang coefficient of friction is equal lang sa tangent sa angle of friction. So, angle of friction is just equal to arctan of coefficient of friction, and that is 0.25. So arctan of 0.25 is equal to 14.04 degrees. So kaning angle phi sub s, pwede na nato siya i-denote na equal lang siya sa 14.04 degrees. Okay, the next is reaction between wedge B and block C. So same lang, na I normal reaction, perpendicular sa surface. Let's denote that as N sub 2. And then ang directions of friction is dapat pasaka based sa direction nato sa impending motion. So we have F sub S sub 2. Then isahon lang nato ni sila, kaning duha. Kuhaon na tong resultant. And let's denote this as R sub 2. Tapos ang angle niya with respect sa normal force, that is the angle of friction, which is equal to 14.04 degrees. Karon na nanatay tulo ka forces, force P, kato required, R sub 1 and R sub 2. Let's apply the triangle rule in equilibrium to solve only for R sub 2 na in terms of variable P. So, unahon nato draw ang force P. Vertically downward. So, that is force P. Then, i-connect nato yung head with the tail sa R sub 1. So, this is our R sub 1. The next is, connect na tong head sa R sub 1 with the tail sa R sub 2. So, this is our R sub 2. Next is, kuha na to mga interior angles so that we can apply later on the sine law. So, for R sub 1, pwede na ito kuhaon ng angle with respect sa vertical. So, gamito na ito ni, sa itong FBD, ang kanina angle. Let's denote this angle as angle alpha. Take note that this angle with respect to the vertical equal lang po sa kanina interior angle. So, angle alpha, kung isum up ni mo siya with 14.04 degrees, and this 6 degrees, dapat ang total nila is equal to 90 degrees. Because take note, ang normal force and ang friction force, 90 degrees ang ilahang angle in between. So, kung isum up ni mo ang tulo, dapat mo equal to 90. So, with this equation, we can now solve the angle alpha, which is equal to 69.96 degrees. Therefore, this angle is equal to 69.96. Next is we can solve this angle now with respect to the vertical sa between sa R sub 2 and force P. So kanina angle is equal sa kanina angle based sa itong FBD. So if we solve this angle, this should be equal to 90 degrees minus 14.04 degrees. So this is equal to 75.96 degrees. So, angle sa R sub 2 with respect sa vertical should be equal to 75.96 degrees. The next is kaning last interior angle sa triangle. Let's denote this as angle beta. So, kanang angle beta is equal lang na siya sa, since ang sum sa interior angle sa triangle is 180. So, ang beta is equal to 180 minus these two interior angles. So, beta is equal to 34.08 degrees. karon na kumpleto na ato mga interior angles, we can now solve for R sub 2 na in terms of variable P. So let's apply sine law. So by sine law, R sub 2 over sine of its opposite angle, which is 69.96 degrees, is equal to force P over the sine of its opposite angle, which is beta, and beta is 34.08 degrees. Thus, our R sub 2 in terms of variable P is equal to 1.677 P. So, kanina force class ang atong ipasa dito sa atong next FBD, which is katong block C. Okay, so for block C, i-draw na ito iyang FBD. So, using this figure, let's expose the forces acting on block C. So, na iyang weight nag-act sa iyang center of gravity. So, equal to 10 kilonewtons. And then, next is, ipasa nato ni R sub 2. So, before nato hindi siya ipasa, unahaw na ito pasa ang kanyang mga reaction components. Kailangan lang nato ang tamang orientation sa R sub 2. So, para ipasa ni N sub 2 and F sub S sub 2, gamitan nato Newton's third law. So, by Newton's third law, mabaliktad lang ang direction sa kaning duha. So, therefore, sa atong FBD, atong N sub 2 is directed to the right. Tapos, ato ang friction force is downward. So, ang orientation karon sa ato ang resultant force is ingani. So, R sub 2 is equal to 1.677 P based sa itong nasolve nganina. So, take note class para dili mo makonfuse sa tamang drawing sa R sub 2. I-drawing sa ninyo una ang components, then ang ilang arrowhead is pointing dito sa point of application. Tapos, in between sa ilaha is na dito nakalocate ang resultant force sa kaning duha na components. Okay, then next is i-label nato ang angle of friction. So, angle of friction again is with respect to the normal force. So, this is 14.04 degrees. Next is, we have to take note ng impending motion sa block C is padulong sa right. So, naatay normal reaction sa surface na horizontal na N sub 3. Then, based sa atong direction sa impending motion, dapat ang ato ang friction na F sub S sub 3 is directed to the left. So, directed to the left. So, isahon gyapon, combine nato N sub 3 and kaning friction force. Kuhaon nato ilang resultant. So, i-denote nato na as R sub 3. Then again, by using the concept of angle of friction, kana siya na angle with respect sa normal force is equal to 14.04 degrees. So, ang target nato diri ana FBD is i-relate ang R sub 2 na naka in terms of variable P, which is katong target nato, i-relate nato sa given value na force, which is kaning weight sa block C. Okay, so una, i-drawing sa nato ang triangle using triangle rule in equilibrium. Okay, unahon nato ang 10 kilonewton force. Then next, ang head sa 10 kilonewtons, pwede na ito i-connect sa tail sa R sub 2. So, let's denote this as our R sub 2, which is equal to 1.677 P. Then lastly is, connect na ito ng head sa R sub 2 with the tail sa R sub 3. So, this is our R sub 3. After drawing the sides of the triangle, pwede na nato kumpletuhon ang angles para maka-apply tag sine law. So, with respect sa vertical, ang R sub 3, ang iyang angle is 14.04 degrees. So this angle is equal to 14.04 degrees. Then next, with respect sa horizontal, kung mag-create tag horizontal line diri, ang kanina angle is equal sa kanina angle. So kung tanawon po nato sa picas, sa taas niya na side, so kani siya is also 14.04 degrees. So kani is 14.04 degrees, and we know that this is 90 degrees. Since vertical niya and horizontal niya, so that creates a 90 degree angle. So ato lang isum up ang 90 and 14.04 degrees to get this angle. So again, this angle is equal to 90 plus 14.04 degrees. So that is equal to 104.04 degrees. Then for this angle, pwede na nato ni makuha using the concept of the sum of interior angles of the triangle. So that angle is equal to 180 minus 14.04 and minus this angle 104.04 degrees. So that is equal to 61.92 degrees. Karon na kumpleto na itong interior angles, we can now apply sine law to solve for the force P. So i-relate na itong R sub 2 and 10 kilonewtons. So R sub 2 equal to 1.677 P over the sine of its opposite angle, which is 14.04 degrees. Is equal to 10 kilonewtons sine of the over sine of its opposite angle, which is 61.92 degrees. Okay, so we have now an equation with one unknown. So solving for the magnitude of P, you can get that P is equal to 1.640 kilonewtons. So ang direction is gihatag na sa problem, which is panaog. So we write the direction of force P to be downward. And this will be our final answer for this problem. Okay, so that's sample problem 4. For sample problem number 6, we are given this system composing of a lever and a wheel. So, diri akla sa kanina given na system, connected ang wheel and kaning lever by a rope. Tapos, a force P is applied. Ang magnitude niya is 30 newtons to the handle of the lever. Na due to this application of force sa lever, ay possible rotation or impending rotation na mahitabo about point C, or this support is hinge C. So kung diri ata magtanaw, posible na mag-rotate ang lever about this point. Since take note class, ang hinge support is ma-resist lang niya ang motion na translation, pero diri siya ka-resist of rotation. So allowed ang rotation diri ana point, about point C. So wala siya ihatag na reaction moment, only reactions lang na force components, katong X and Y components. So kung i-apply na ning 30 newtons, na impending rotation na mahitabo about point C, na ang direction is pa-clockwise. So kaning lever, posible siya na mo-rotate pa-clockwise about point C. Once kaning lever is mo-rotate pa-clockwise point C, that would mean na kani pong tali is masabay since connected man siya sa lever. So kung impending rotation sa lever is clockwise, that would mean na ang impending rotation po sa tali is clockwise. So, kaning tali na nakapulupot sa wheel, or kaning belt rather, since ang pagka-state diri sa problem is belt and wheel. So, kaning belt na nakapulupot sa wheel, ang impending motion sa belt is mag-rotate siya pa-clockwise. Karon, kung kaning belt is mo-rotate pa-clockwise, and mauto iya ang impending motion, kaning wheel is na tendency na musabay po dito sa tali. So based sa problem, na-resistance sa tali na couple moment M such that na kaning wheel is dili mag-rotate once applyan og force P na 30 newtons diri sa lever. So mag-resist ning wheel. So kung mag-resist siya, ang kaning moment dapat iyang direction is counterclockwise. And that's the reason nga nung counterclockwise ang ibutang na direction diri as a given. So ang required is to solve for m, that value of m, and of course ang direction niya is counterclockwise. Now to solve for this value of m, pwede nato ibungkago ng kanina system, then i-analyze nato isa-isa ang lever and ang kaning wheel. So pwede ka mag-start to analyze sa lever, tapos mukuha ka equations containing kaning duha ka tension, and pwede, then next mag-proceed ka sa FBD sa wheel. Or pwede po either pabaliktad diri ka sa wheel tapos mo-add to ka sa lever pag-analyze ka. So either way tama lang. Ang kailangan lang i-take note diri is present ang friction between sa belt and wheel. That would mean na kaning tension na naka-attach sa point D is not equal sa tension na naka-attach sa point A or ang line of action na niagi sa point A. So magkaiba ilang value. So katuwa itong i-take note. So therefore, magamit ta og formula sa belt or rope friction. So for this problem, ang i-present lang ako is mag-start ko sa wheel ug analyze, and then kuha tag equations, tapos i-gamito na to as our next FBD kaning lever. Okay, so mag-start ta sa FBD sa wheel. So sa kaning ligid is of course na itali, no? Na nakapulupot sa iyaha, so na tension na mag-act sa kaning body, and always ang tension is pabira ang ilang direction. So diriya is na tension na pwede nato i-denote as T sub D since connected siya at point D sa lever. So iningin lang nato as T sub D. And then ang isa is pabira po ang direction. Let's name that as T sub A. Diri sa point B, makita nato na that is a hinge support. So that means na ay reaction at that support na dapat nato i-expose. So na ay B sub Y and B sub X. So kana na point is point B. And kaning B sub Y and B sub X, dili man nato ni kailangan kuwao na values. So later on, ma-neglect lang yapon nato na kung mag-moment about point B. And then next is ang target nato na moment. So na ay moment na or reaction moment na kailangan mag-act sa wheel or mag-react diri sa wheel para dili siya mo-rotate due to this impending motion pag-apply sa force P. So again, take note class na impending motion is pa-clockwise. Okay, so based sa impending motion, since pa-clockwise siya, so pasabot ani kaning posibilidad na mag-move ang tali is musabay siya sa direction sa force na T sub D or tension T sub D. So kung musabay siya ani, that would mean na kaning T sub D is greater than T sub A since pasabay ang impending motion sa iyang direction. So we can write T sub D is greater than T sub A. Okay, so kung magamit at tag-formula na T sub 2 over T sub 1 is equal to E raised to mu sub S times the angle of contact beta, makaning T sub D will represent as our T sub 2 and T sub A will represent our T sub 1. So again class, another point day na kailangan i-take note nato is kaning reaction moment na dapat mo act sa wheel so that it will not rotate due to the impending motion sa belt. Dili na siya reaction moment na nag-exist diri sa kaning support, hinge support. Since we know na ang hinge support is dili siya makahatag og resistance against rotation. Only translation lang, so B sub y and B sub x lang. So, naay some mechanism na dili nag-i-explain sa problem na maghatag sa wheel og resistance against rotation na para ma-prevent ang pag-rotate na napaklockwise. So, ato siya is dili nag-iingon sa problem basta kay mo resist ang wheel. So, naay resistance against rotation na target nato i-solve ang katunang moment. So, diriya sa atong FBD class is daghan kay tag unknowns. So, natay lima ka unknown na variables. Tapos, ang B sub y and B sub x din nato kailangan. So, ang moment is katogid atong punteriya. Kaning T sub A and T sub D is kailangan nato i-consider maski dili ni atong main requirement because naay friction na nag-occur sa belt. Therefore, magamit ta og formula sa friction. Tapos, kaning T sub A and T sub D is ma-relate nato siya sa next FBD since kanina kaning duha ka forces nag-exist ni siya sa atong next FBD. So sa kanina FBD class sa ligid is kanilang moment, tension sub A and tension sub D ang atong concern. So manguha tag mga equations involving these three variables. Tapos likayan nato ang getting an equation na naay B sub x and B sub y. So likayan nato ang summation of forces along x and y since mugawas dito ang B sub x and B sub y. So for tension A and tension D, magamit nato siya by applying this formula sa belt friction. So ma-involve nato ang kaning duha na variables. So i-substitute lang nato class ang diriya sa formula ang kaning duha na tension. And mu sub s is already given 0.3. Pero ang beta is kailangan nato i-identify. So based sa problem, ang kaning beta is moto angle of contact na nakapulupot sa wheel. So gikan diri a class, gikan diri ana point, patulong diri ana point. So painganian yang tuyo. So almost 360 degrees, short lang siya og 90 degrees para totally makapulupot siya. So kung tanawon nato no ang degrees sa pulupot niya, that is 270 degrees. And 270 degrees, kung i-convert nato sa radian, so pwede natin i-multiply. Multiply nato with conversion factor. Pi rad. So 180 is equal to pi rad. Cancel ang degrees. So we have beta is equal to 3 pi over 2. So, this is our angle of contact. Take note, beta dapat naka-radian na siya sa itong formula pag itong i-substitute. Okay, so, substitute lang nato ang T sub D, then over T sub A equal to E raised to mu sub S. Mu sub S is 0.3. And then beta is 3 pi over 2. Excuse me. So we can get T sub D is equal to T sub A. So multiplied by E raised to 0.3 times 3 pi over 2. So natay makuha na relationship between these two tension. That tension or T sub D is equal to 4.1112 T sub A. So, karon na natay relationship sa duha ka tension. Gamitan gyapon nato ni na FBD to relate the moment with the tension. So, ang buhatan nato is mag-take ta og moment sa B, cancel out ang B sub X and B sub Y. So, taking moment about point B. So, positive ang reaction moment na M. Then, positive po ang tension A. Then, ang moment arm niya is katong radius sa wheel. So, 0.3. Then, minus tension sa D times 0.3. Tension sa D is equal to 4.1112 D sub A times moment arm na 0.3. Then, equal to 0. So, based sa kanina equation, we can express M in terms of T sub A. So M is equal to 0.9336 T sub A. Since na natay equation sa moment na naka in terms of T sub A, kailangan na lang natukuha ng value sa T sub A para makuha na gid nato ang magnitude and of course ma-state nato ang direction sa moment. So kaning value sa T sub A is pwede nato siya makuha kung i-analyze nato ang isa pa ka FBD. So dito nato kuha ng isa pa ka relationship na pangkuha sa value sa T sub A. So ang sunod na FBD nato is FBD sa lever. So sa kanin FBD is exposed na itong mga forces na nag-a-act sa lever na ay 30 newtons. And then sa D is na tension. Tension is always pabira ang iyahang direction. So T sub D. And we know that T sub D, based sa itong nakuha ganina, no, that is equal to 4.1112 T sub A. Then next is kaning tension sa point A, that is T sub A. And also, ma-expose po na to ang reaction components at point C. So let's assume the direction na C sub Y is upward, C sub X is to the right. So C sub Y and C sub X, dili na to kailangan. So ang buhatan natin is mag-moment sa point C so that we will have a moment equation na T sub A lang ang mga variables. Okay, so taking moment about point C. So let's start with T sub A. So negative ang mahatag niya na moment about point C. With respect to point C, ang moment arm is 0.06. Then plus, sa next is kaning T sub D. Magnitude niya is equal to 4.1112 T sub A. Positive since pa-counterclockwise siya about point C. Then ang iyahang moment arm is equal to 0.025. And lastly is this 30 Newton force. So minus 30 times its moment arm about point C is 0.7, then equal to 0. So we have an equation with only one unknown, patong T sub A. So we can solve the value of T sub A equal to 490.88 newtons. So using this magnitude sa T sub A, we cannot compute the value of moment. So moment is equal to 0.9336, so based sa kanina equation, times T sub A no 490.88. So our moment is equal to 458.29 Newton meter, and direction is counterclockwise. So this is our final answer for this problem. Okay, so that's problem 6, and that's it for now. Thank you, class, and God bless.